Greetings and welcome to LNS. Welcome to another episode of Let's Play The Binding of Isaac Rebirth. Let's hope for some good runs. Sorry if my voice is a little weird, just ate. Let me go ahead and open Isaac. Going on 160 hours now, wow. Man, that's a lot of time.
Isaac and his mother lived alone in a small house on a hill. Isaac kept to himself, drawing pictures and playing with his toys as his mom watched Christian broadcasts on the television. Life was simple, and they were both happy. That was until the day Isaac's mom heard a voice from above. Your son has become corrupted by sin. He needs to be saved. I will do my best to save him, my lord, Isaac's mother replied, rushing into Isaac's room, removing all that was evil from his life. Again, the voice called to her. Isaac's soul is still corrupt. He needs to be cut off from all that is evil in this world and confess his sins. I will follow your instructions, Lord. I have faith in thee, Isaac's mother replied, as she locked Isaac in his room, away from the evils of the world. One last time, Isaac's mom heard the voice of God calling to her. You've done as I've asked, but I still question your devotion to me. To prove your faith, I will ask one more thing of you. Yes, Lord, anything. Isaac's mother begged. To prove your love and devotion, I require a sacrifice. Your son, Isaac, will be this sacrifice. Go into his room and end his life as an offering to me to prove you love me above all else. Yes, Lord, she replied, grabbing a butcher's knife from the kitchen. Isaac, watching through a crack in his door, trembled in fear. Scrambling around his room to find a hiding place, he noticed a trap door to the basement hidden under his rug. Without hesitation, he flung open the hatch, just as his mother burst through his door and threw himself down into the unknown depths below.
Okay. How is everyone this wonderful evening, I think it is? Pretty sure it's evening. Alright, let's see what's going on here. Judas just needs boss rush. Finally finished out Azazel. Samson's done. Eden just needs boss rush too. So that's two people that just need boss rush. Lazarus needs a chest kill. And Eve needs a chest kill. Oh man, I just played Eve and I just played Lazarus too. It's a tough call. I think I'm gonna go with Eve though. Because I think Eve was like a night ago or something. Not last night, but one night before that. Seed for this run is going to be ZV219AH. M for anybody who wants to play along. Oh, it's okay, Mr. Toxics, don't worry. I'm not a huge streamer. I know people have lives. It's completely okay. Besides, if you ever want to catch up on past streams, they're all over YouTube. And they never get views, so, I mean, even getting one view would be pretty surprising to me. It's because I think YouTube has a really bad algorithm for showing off small channels' videos. Like, basically, YouTube looks at how much money a channel makes, and they're like, oh, this channel makes money, we need to promote them so they make even more money. But the small ones, yeah, no. How I've been doing? Do you mean how you've been doing? Is that a... I don't know. If you mean how you've been doing, I've been pretty good. Pretty okay. Kinda was a little under the weather on Monday, so there was no stream on Monday, but... I'm feeling better now, that's for sure. I'm feeling like Isaac's it's getting done. And I can't believe I'm going on 160 hours of Isaac. It's amazing. But then again, you wouldn't even believe how much Red Alert 2 I've played. I think Origin says I'm up to like 70 hours of Red Alert 2. But I mean, I can't really explain why. It's just, it's a good game. It's a really good game. I can't wait to get into Red Alert 3. If it's anything like Red Alert 2, it's gonna be just fantastic. And besides, I never really played Command & Conquer when I was younger. So it's kind of cool that I actually get to play it now because I own every single one of them. Ah, some bitch. Come on, don't take any more damage. I can't take even one more hit. Oh, thank God the pooters died. Hold on a second. Oh, come on. Dead bird, why are you not getting in there and doing some damage? Yo, bro. Oh, it's okay. I totally understand that you don't have time for the streams. They're so long. And yet, I still have people that want me to stream longer. And don't get me wrong, I mean, I'd love to stream longer too. Like, the first time I ever streamed, like ever, I think I was playing Kirby for GBA, and I streamed for like 7 hours. I didn't even understand what the concept of time was with that stream. It was so much fun. And then I had a day-long stream where I streamed for like 10 hours, I think, and it was streaming Rift. I was doing that for the charity, what was it called? Extra Life, I think? I think that's what it's called? The Children's Foundation. Unfortunately, I didn't raise any money, but the stream was sure fun. Nobody watched it except for one person that was from Facebook, but hey, it was still super fun. But unfortunately, that doesn't work now. That's cool. Yeah, if you've gotta wait till summer, that's fine. I won't be here all summer. Because we're gonna go on vacation and go see my dad in Colorado. And so I will be gone then, and I'll be gone like a week after that or something. A week shortly after there. Because I have to go watch my mother's animals while they go to my sister's wedding. Well, one of my sister's weddings. I can't do it because I'm broke. But they're gonna do it, and they've got animals, and they're gonna be there for like a week, so I was like, yeah, you know what, I'll go ahead and watch the animals. And I won't be able to take the computer with me, so unfortunately, no streams. It would've been great, though, because it would've been good streams. I could've streamed all day, every day, if I wanted to. Because nobody would be on the internet to tell me not to. I might have a weekend extravaganza here sometime. It just depends upon if my wife and her parents are gonna go camping like they said they were going to. They're not sure. Sometimes they're just trying to figure out if it's actually gonna work or not. And if so, because I mean, I hate camping, so if they want to do it, that's fine. And I'll be here all by myself, so I will be able to stream a lot. For at least 2 days or whatnot. And that might help me get viewers. Because I'm definitely believing what Vinesauce, or Vinny said from Vinesauce. it's really hard to get viewers, like really hard. It's kind of just a right place, right time kind of scenario. Although I gotta say that getting viewers on Twitch is certainly easier than getting viewers on YouTube. YouTube is just impossible. And then I watched some video where it was like, trying to figure out how to get views by paying for them. You know, like paying advertising, trying to figure out how to do advertising. And the guy's like, well, it's not a good idea to advertise if your channel's doing bad, because that's not gonna help any because you're already getting no views or whatnot. I'm like, well then how do you get the views in the first place? Because YouTube isn't doing a very good job of advertising, obviously. I get like 40 views a day, it's pathetic. For 400 videos, it's really bad. And not even all those videos are like super long like my streams, and they're pretty long. I can understand some people maybe not wanting to watch those. But then again, I just watched a 3-hour stream from Vinny on his Vine Sauce channel. And it was fantastic, I loved it. So, I mean, there's gonna be people that'll watch it. So it's no problem. No, you didn't tell me you did your first stream. How was it? And what did you play? And do you have any questions? I mean, I'm not like a pro streamer or anything, but I've got a pretty good setup here. Even for a really crappy internet. Oh god, I lost my Horror of Babylon, that sucks. I just realized that because my tiers are super small now. And this is gonna be a chest run. Oh, thank god I never have to do the dark room ever again if I don't want to. Because actually, you know, the chest is better anyway. What is this? Good stuff? Paralysis, not so good. But not too bad. Mom's eye's not too bad. I was really hoping that was Mom's contact. If I get Dr. Fetus, I'll be screwed. Oh god. That guy just went for me like a missile. Jeez. Very, very scary. Oh, Jesus. Good lord. Are you one of the fast ones? Yeah, I think you are. I don't like this room at all. Let's get out of here pronto. Not a good room. Oh. It's terrible. Oh. Careful. Sneak a shot in there. There we go. Oh, you played Dying Light? And for like 10 seconds I had like 10 viewers? But then it was at 2? Wow, how'd you get 10 viewers that quickly? On your first stream? That's amazing. Then again, it could be because Dying Light is a pretty new game, if I remember correctly. Probably one of those that's trending pretty highly. Looks interesting. I don't think it looks like my type of game, but it's a good one to watch. I like it. I would probably suck at it though. It looks kind of Mirror's Edge-y. And I wasn't very good at Mirror's Edge. I think I played it like once because my brother had it and I was like, I don't know about it. Not very good with FPSs. It might have been a glitch with the viewer count. I know my viewer count kind of glitches out every now and then too. Nothing like that. That would make me just be like, what? But it glitches and says, hey, you have viewers when I don't have viewers. Or maybe I do. Sometimes you can't tell if there's viewers. Because even if you look at the viewer list, there's no names there. Because they're like guests. And I don't think guests can ever have names and they can't chat. Or like people that don't have Twitch accounts. So for all I know, I mean, I could have 20 viewers right now and not even know it. Probably don't, though. I'm taking Tim the Tatman. I think it's... I'm pretty sure that's his name. Tim Tattoo... I don't know. Whatever he is. Tim the Tattoo Guy or whatever. Taking his advice and just... He was saying, don't ever really look at your viewers. You don't want to look at that number because it can be very disheartening. Because sometimes you can have streams where you'll have like 10 viewers and then your next stream you'll have like 2 or you'll have like 0. And he's like, if you just don't look at it, you don't get your hopes up, you don't do anything like that. So I was like, oh, that's pretty cool. Oh, people were talking in chat? Nice. And you got one follower, nice. That's a pretty good starting stream, I'd say. Lord knows I didn't do that good. I think mine... I went on for like a week before I got my first person to come and chat. Of course, my first game that I ever streamed wasn't a super popular game. It's a good game, but it's not super popular. It was, Forge Quest. Pretty good game, though. I'm kind of going a little fast, because I'm hoping maybe for Boss Rush as well. Because I know Eve needs Boss Rush as well. So that would be nifty if I could just kind of throw that in as a bonus. I don't know if it's going to happen, though. Might decide to go double Horror Babylon. With this boss, depending upon who it is. Please die, thank you. Oh, they said hi and then left. Yeah, I know. I know how that feels. I get those guys. I think they're trolls, pretty much. They just come in, say hi, and then just automatically leave. Or maybe they don't understand the lag that Twitch has. And since they say hi, it always takes like a couple of seconds for Twitch chat to actually recognize that they said something. And then it takes even longer to get to the actual streamer. And so by then they might be like, well, this person's not even acknowledging my existence. I wish Twitch would let people know that there's a little bit of a lag. Because it's not perfectly live. Nothing really can be. It's really bad. Really bad. Really bad damage. Oh, did I even go to the item room here? I don't think I did. Ooh, Joker card. I like that. I have not gone to the item room. I haven't found it yet. Yeah, I got somebody to come in and say hi, and then they were just gone. And I asked my buddy Sossels about it. He's another streamer. And he's like, yeah, I've had that happen before. He doesn't understand why people do it. Nah, I'm not a huge fan of Counter-Strike. Like I said, I'm not a huge fan of FPSs altogether. The only FPS I really liked was one that nobody likes. But I found it pretty good. I'll take the left hand, I suppose. If it's just gonna sit there and wait, I might as well take it. Time is still... it's okay, but unfortunately... well, I'm on Caves 2, so it's possible. I thought I was on Caves 1. I'll try this. Yeah, it was worth it. I mean, not super worth it, but not too bad. Oh, careful. Why do you guys still move when you're in your little goo piles? That's not right. Shouldn't happen. Okay, I'm not gonna worry about that. Let us run to the boss real quick and then I'll check chat. I'll probably pause it when I check chat because I need to hopefully keep this boss rush alive. Let's grab this Empress card so maybe I can... oh yeah, double Horror Babylon sounds good with Gertie. Double Horror Babylon. Oh wait, no, never mind. This is just single Horror Babylon because I'm not in my actual Horror Babylon. Dang it. It'll take a little while, but it's okay. Still doing quite a bit of damage to Gertie, I'd say. when you're doing this kind of damage to Gertie, you know you got a pretty decent run. Of course, that was with War of Avalon, so I don't know if it's going to be that good. Wow, damage plus HP up is great. That's not so good. Not so good. Wow, I had the speed to actually lose that bomb. Telepills! Oh, why did it have to be telepills? Well, you know what? I think I'm just gonna donate. Oop. And that extra cent, too. Please don't jam. Thank you. Okay, now let me check chat. Do you have it? I think it's okay. Well, I don't have Counter-Strike Go. Because it costs money. And I mean, I can't even afford Skullgirls, which is on sale and actually looks like a pretty decent game. I looked at the sale price and I'm like, man, $3, that's so cheap, I can't afford it. I mean, I've made like $10 with YouTube, but the way YouTube works, you can't touch your money, you can't actually have it as actual tangible money until you make $100. And, I mean, I'm being completely honest with myself, that's just never gonna happen. It's seriously, it's gonna take like 20 years to make $100 at this rate. Unless something magical happens. Which it could. It's possible. It's just not probable. Oh, come on. Are you kidding me? You were poisoned, I saw that. I got these poison tears, which are kind of nice. Please die. Thank you. I probably should not have gone in that room, because it took way more time than I thought I was going to. Whoa, that was close. Oh, that's not good. Come on. Oh my god, really? Stop taking dumb damage. Please die. Thank you. One thing that I do really want to get into is corruptions. I was watching Vinny do corruptions, and oh my god, they look so much fun. I don't know if I'd be any good at it, but I would love to try it. Skullgirls is a some kind of a fighting game that's on Steam right now for like $2.99. I was like, hey, if I was a bigger streamer and actually got that as a gift, hell yes, I would stream that. It looks pretty darn good. It's an indie fighting game. I was looking at it and I was like, man, $3. Wow, I wish I had it. I might be able to get I Am Bread though, because I've got a coupon for it and it would make it like $7 or something. I think my wife will allow me to get that. Oh, corruption? Corruptions are where you corrupt a ROM. So, like, you play an SNES ROM, and you corrupt the crap out of it, and sprites just start messing up, sounds mess up. It's pretty entertaining. And it's always different, too. That's the cool thing about it. That Wheel of Fortune's interesting. I don't know if I'll use it. Well, I guess I did use it. The Magician's not very good. But I gotta move a little bit faster if I want to make this boss rush in a reality. Yeah, I don't think it's gonna happen. Because this is just Necropolis 1. Unfortunately, I don't think it's gonna happen, because one of the floors took far too long. So I'll be a little more meticulous here. But yeah, so, corruptions are like, if you ever played the NES, and you saw all these weird shapes, and then you took it out and blew on the cartridge to make it work, those are corruptions. Corruptions are like glitches that you can make happen, and then it changes the way the game plays. I saw Vinny do some great, awesome corruptions. so I'd really like to get into it, because I know it's free and it's difficult, but one of the corruptors looked like it was really quite easy to use. So I might try that. Just to see if maybe people would like that. I mean, I wouldn't give up on Isaac, of course. I mean, I love Isaac too much to stop playing Isaac. Maybe you'll see a gift soon? Well, unfortunately not for me. I have $0. If I had more money, I would definitely gift to people though, because I mean, I got gifted Isaac, so that's pretty great. And I feel like sharing the love with people, but you know, no money doesn't equal being able to share the love with people, unfortunately. My name on Steam is just my name, or just my stream name. Oh, come on, really? I don't want to be getting hit by all those blood bullets. It's ridiculous. Pyromaniac is a really good item. Really good. Almost stupidly broken item. Because now, my bombs are basically potions. Ipecac shots are potions to me. And not only is it a potion, it's also a potion that could potentially do damage to other enemies as well. I'm not gonna get boss rush, that's for sure. I'm just not fast enough, and these floors have been a little weird. Just a little bit. Yeah, it's already gone. Been gone for 44 seconds and I'm still on Necropolis 1. I can't believe this. But I might as well explore it all. Usually to get boss rush, you have to like not shoot poop, not shoot fires, and whatnot. But yeah, like the game looked really good. I don't know how long it's for sale though. It might be for sale for the rest of the week, I believe, because it was Midweek Madness, or part of Midweek Madness, anyway. So I think it's like a 3-day sale. And I mean, the game's usually like 12 bucks for Skullgirls, so I was like, $3? That's a heck of a deal. If I did not have the monetary value of zero, I would take advantage of that deal. And I would stream it too, because that looks like a good game. Although I'm not that good at fighting games. I have Guilty Gear and I have yet to beat it, so. And I have Street Fighter Alpha Anthologies or something like that. It's a pretty good game. Oh, you're gonna buy it for me? You're gonna gift it to me? You know, if you want to, you can get it for yourself, too. I think it might have multiplayer. Maybe. I don't know. I'd stream it, though, if you did gift it to me. Definitely. I don't know if I'd stream it soon. I Am Bread is... I have a coupon for it right now for 50% off for I Am Bread. So I'm just kind of waiting for my wife. Because she said she'll get that for me, so... I am totally getting that. Because it looks really, really ridiculous. Cool. Well, thank you, man. That is super nice. And I will definitely stream it, so you can definitely see what it's like. Although, it does say it has partial nudity in it, so I'm kind of hoping that's not going to be like, hey, Twitch is gonna be like, hey, this has got nudity in it, you can't stream it. I'll be like, come on, please. I don't think it's gonna have too much nudity. It probably just has, like, some upskirts or something. I think I saw some upskirts and whatnot, but the action looks fantastic. And I mean, it's all girls, so it's girls. It's fine with me. I'm a guy, I like girls. That's the way we're supposed to be. That's kind of funny too. My wife wonders that too. She's like, well, when you play a game, why do you always pick a girl? It's like, because I'm a guy in real life. Why in the hell would I want to make a guy in a game? You know? Games are all about living your fantasies, which is taking yourself into another world. And if you roll a guy in a game and you're already a guy, then, you know, did I already beat this boss? Yes, I did. I need to go get my Joker card. There it is. But I didn't get my deal with the devil, so I'm gonna force myself to have a deal with the angel. That works for me. People stream GTA 5, so that's 10 times worse. Oh, that is true, that is true. Wait, does that have actual nudity in it, GTA 5? I don't think it does it? It's just like really, really, like, sexual innuendo or something like that? Because I know, Saints Row has, well, it kind of has nudity. It has like a censor bar or something like that. Maggie's Faith is straight up not a very good item. Don't give it to me, please. Don't give me the broken onk either. I'd rather have the left hand. Two spades is okay, I'll take it. And then I'll take my Empress and go ahead and blow this thing away. Maybe get a soul heart. Maybe not. Maybe just a red heart. I don't really want Judas's tongue. Oh well, that's okay. Let's get out of here. Naked guys, naked girls, and even a strip club? Wow. And Twitch doesn't care? Wow. I might do some streaming of some novels that I have then. Maybe. I don't know, though. I don't know how much people would like visual novels. I mean, I thought it was a good game. And it only has one scene in it. That's the thing that's pissed me off so much, is that Steam decided to censor every part of that game that has anything to do with anything at all, even if it's not even sex. Like, one time the main character catches the, like, camp counselor with her shirt off or something, and you can't even see anything at all. Because I actually found the, like, cracked version of it. But it's a free game, too. It's a good game, too. But yeah, like, I saw that and I was like, why in the hell did they censor this? All you see is you see a back. She has a bra on. She has underwear on. There's no nudity at all, just a naked back. Apparently a naked back is very, very sexual, I guess. I did not know this. Oh, I don't even have to worry about blowing up, that's right. I can have bomb flies blow up in my face all day long, I'm okay with that. I'll trade one for one, sure. I don't know if I want to go there. So yeah, I think all you have to do is just friend me on Steam. That's what Coconut Pocky did. He just surprised me while I was playing the pirated version of Isaac. Because we couldn't get the streams or the seeds to work correctly, and so he just surprised me with this, like, black window, and I was like, well, this black window isn't loading, so I don't know what it is. And then after it loaded, it was just like, hey, you have a gift of the Binding of Isaac. I was like, seriously? That's crazy. I didn't even know it. Didn't even ask for it. Which I think is super cool. Because I don't want to be one of those guys that's like, hey, give me all the stuff. Doesn't mean I don't actually want all the stuff, but I don't want to be one that's like, give me all the stuff. I think I should have to get it for myself. It's just I really need to get my career working. Because since I can't get hired for a job, I figure I'll just do this and hopefully someday make some money. I'm not imagining I'm gonna be like PewDiePie, because I don't think I'm that. Well, I don't know if I could count PewDiePie as being entertaining. Apparently some people think he's entertaining, but to me, I don't think he's very entertaining. He's incredibly annoying. Like, even somebody sent me, like, his best video. They're like, oh my god, this is so funny, you should totally watch it. And I tried watching it, and I was like, what? This is not funny. He's not funny. Oh, crap. Crap, crap, crap. There we go. Well, thanks a lot. That's very nice. I appreciate the kind words as well. This is the reason why I stream. Because I knew people out there would like it. Especially, I mean, who doesn't like Isaac? Seriously. Well, I mean, I'm sure there's going to be people out there that don't like Isaac. Don't get me wrong. I was kind of one of those that's like, hey, weird. Isaac is, you know, kind of creepy. I don't know if I really like it or not. But now that I've played it, oh my god, I love Isaac. It's fantastic. And I was okay with bombing myself there, because like I said, I can use my bombs as potions now. I love it. Where was that donation machine? I lost it. Where did you go? Where did you go, donation machine? I think it was up here. That soul heart is tempting. Yeah, it's right here. Oh my gosh, if I could get to 99! Ouch. Not what I wanted. The run is really strong, it's just, the shot speed is so slow. Maybe that's why I couldn't get the boss rush. I think it was causing me to be just a little bit slower. So yeah, if you send me a friend request, just let me know beforehand so that when it pops up I can just go ahead and accept it. Coconut didn't let me know, so I was just like, okay. At least if you let me know, I'll be on the lookout for it. Oh goodness, no, stay away, thank you. Do I like this pill? I do not like that pill. Crap. It is a very difficult game. But it can sometimes be so face roll easy too, which is really cool. But I mean, if you try a game, if you try FTL, that's a game that's just punishingly hard pretty much all the time. I mean, it's not a bad game. It has a terrible boss that's no fun, and you almost never beat the boss, but the game itself is pretty fun. And I might stream some FTL too. I mean, just don't expect me to actually win. I think I've beaten the game like twice. And each one was just completely luck. And I've played it some like 40 some odd times. And only two wins, that's pretty bad odds. Ooh. I like that. I don't like that. Maybe some goodness here? Of a Cyndaquil? Nice. Alright, yeah, just go ahead and do that. Oh my goodness! I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna roll blank card Empress. Let's do this. It's gonna be fantastic. I love the blank card, and I haven't had a chance to use it enough. You know, I'm still gonna take left hand, I think. Would you please get out of the way? Blank card! That's, I was gonna say double Whore of Babylon, but that's not true. Oh my god, Mom's Eye with the Mom's Fight is actually pretty good. Or Mom Fight. The Mom's Fight. Is actually pretty good, because you can sometimes shoot right behind you and hit two parts of the body at once and not even realize it. Awesome. Well, the higher your luck stat is, anyway. Oh god. Be very careful. Oh jeez. Heard that grunt. That's one of the things that I've got to say with the mom fight that I noticed, is listen for that grunt. Because if you can hear that grunt, you know that the leg is coming soon, and you can just try and get out of the way. Although, technically, I could have let the leg come down on me, because it does explosive damage for some reason. And since I have pyromaniac, you know, all explosions heal me, so I'm okay with that. I'm okay with those bomb little thingy-majiggers coming up and exploding right in my face, too. It could happen. Not these guys, though. These guys can not be alive anymore. That would be very nice. There we go. They could kindly perish. These guys, yeah, I'll take your shots. Aw, what? Come on. It's like when I actually want to get hit by Ipecac shots, I can't do it. But when I don't want to get hit, oh, of course I'll get hit. Is Pin really worth Horde of Babylon? I don't really think so. It's only one single pin? Kidding me? On the womb? They're gonna put me up against one single pin? Alright. I'm not gonna complain, I'm just shocked. It's shocking. Well, thanks, Mr. Toxics. I definitely appreciate it. I have a lot of games for Steam, but I don't really have all that many that are really stream-worthy. Which is sad. I mean, I've got, like... Oh, I love Orcs... Or... Yeah, Orcs Must Die. That's such a good game, but I don't think I can stream it. Unfortunately, because I don't think we have a good enough internet connection. If we had a better internet connection, oh yeah, I'd stream that all, well, not all day long, but, you know, I'd stream it a lot. It's a good game. I have both 1 and 2. My brother got it for me. Because we were supposed to play it, but we never really did play it much. But it's a pretty good game. I like it. Oh god, I didn't even notice that nub there. Jeez. That sucked. He was just sitting there like, hey bro. Hey bro, you don't see me, do you? Not so excited about that speed down. Certainly not excited about that telebills. Although, maybe. If I find a curse room, perhaps. Whoa, careful. Let's see. How is going to be the best way to take out this fine young gentleman here? Oh, that works. I think it was a spider. It works for me. These guys can be super annoying if you get them, if you let them get off their little umbilical cords, I guess. I would say chains, but those are not chains. Those look like the umbilical cord that Gemini has. Oh god. Careful now. I don't like these guys, although they're not the ones that shoot the homing shots, which is definitely better. Man, I wish I could find a better tarot card than Empress. Have you ever seen anybody play with the blank card Jera rune on the chest? Because if you have not seen that, oh my god, you have got to see it. Yeah, you like that mimic kill? It was just a spider kill. The spider was like, hey, I've had enough of this shenaniganry where you're just sitting here doing nothing, staring at each other. And he decided to take matters into his own appendages, because spiders don't have hands. Legs. I was gonna say claws, but, you know, spiders don't really have claws either. That would be scorpions. Yeah, scorpions. They have claws. Or pincers. Oh, that was so nice. That gurgling didn't even get to create creep. Oh, gotta let that creep go away so I can grab the key. Careful! That was really bad. That was more damage than I really wanted to take. Not so good. That's okay. Just be careful, I do have Arachnophobia? I hear ya. I may not have full-blown arachnophobia, but I certainly don't like spiders. Oh, God. That was really dumb. Could you pop up? Like a pop-up video? Come on. There we go. Fantastic. What do you get from Pandora's box on Utero 1? Let's find out. Oh my god, that's fantastic. It's two boss items. Ugh, luck down's not so good. Blue cap is great though, that's tiers... What? I thought that was... Oh, it's shot speed down. Oh, that's not so good. Not so good when you have terrible shot speed like I already have. Oh, careful. This left hand is not paying out so far. I haven't found a single guppy item yet. Not that becoming guppy is gonna be too amazing this run, because my shot speed is awful. Get so scared he'll chase a spider out of the house with a blowtorch? Oh gosh, that sounds a little bit dangerous. I don't think I'd go to that length. I mean, I do kill them. I don't feel good about killing them, because I don't really like killing things, but I just look at it as, you know, if I don't kill it, will this thing maybe bite me? And the answer is, it could. Why did I even do this? I have no money. Ouch. Yeah, I really should have thought that one through. Okay. Where's the secret room? Those are not them. Let's see, it could possibly be right here, maybe. Probably not, though. Oh, it was. Sweet. Oh man, a battery. Are you kidding me? Really, a battery? Holy crap, lit the doghouse on fire for just one spider? He does know the shoes don't cause fire, right? You can use a shoe. That's what I usually use. Actually, I use a flip-flop. They're even flimsier and they still work. Because that's what I wear. Because I think shoes are not very comfortable. Oops, why did I drop that bomb there? I don't know. Good stuff, I can see forever. It's not so good now. Paralysis is not so good. And explosive diarrhea. Wow, those are bad pills. Did I have any hearts? No, I didn't. Not a single one. Not so good. It's gonna be Mr. Fred, right? Oh, double Gertie. Double Gertie is okay. If you can fly. If you can fly, you can just cheat Gertie by flying behind him. And he never is able to shoot you because he can't shoot behind him. Oh no! But with double Gertie, you just kind of gotta focus one. And then just kind of treat the other one like a normal Gertie. With a lot of room to dodge. Which is quite nice. Oh god! Ooh, that was close. I think Ball of Bandages blocked a shot there. Very nice. Fantastic. Range up. I did take a hit. That's not very good. He always likes to watch them curl up. I never even get to see... Well, yeah, that's true. I guess if he burns them, he would see them curl up. Whereas if you squish them, you don't really see them curl up. I saw enough of that in Simant. I used to kill that spider with, like, extreme prejudice. Because that was always such a horrifying game for me as a child. Like, when you're sitting there getting eaten by the spider and it just, like, focuses on it and it says something like, your guts are been eviscerated by the spider or something like that. He turns your guts into liquid goo or something. I'm like, oh man, that's kind of graphic for a kid, jeez. But I mean, it's a good game. It's just incredibly repetitive. I think that might be all the hands. It is. Good. Good, and I do have enough bombs to try this out. Please give me something good. That is acceptable. Not exactly what I was looking for, but it works. Oh god. You guys scare the dickens out of me. Oh god. I didn't even know I had dickens in me, but they scare it out. Right out. Jeez. Taking way too much damage. I'm not gonna grab that quite yet. Just be careful, be calm and cool, and we can get through this without any damage. Yes, good. Okay. I'll come back for that eternal heart later. Didn't mean to take damage there. Where are my red hearts? Where are they? They just not exist. I can kill this guy in a really creative way. It's called walk him into the spikes. Flat. The devil. You know, it's basically like the Empress. But I think it's a better damage up, I think. Yeah, the rapid fire is okay. I don't think it's as good as it could be. But it's okay. It's alright. I only wish I could get some guppy items. Just anything. Except for 9 lives. I probably wouldn't take 9 lives. I'm not gonna chance it for that pill. I could take way too much damage for that. Let's do it. Go into the big room. Book of Belial. The Book of Belial effect on the devil card. What are you guys doing, little diglets? Oh, that's what they are. Maybe not. They're not actually the little diglets from the cave. They look a little different. But they're kind of the same, except for they're not rooted in the one spot. Is that a soul heart? Oh, it was. Nice. Thank you, that was probably Mitre that did that. Not super excited to be fighting double lust here. A little bit fast. At least it's not double super lust, that would be really a nightmare. Thank you. Telepills, yeah. Funny joke, game. Funny joke. Haha. Oh my god, please die, thank you. Fantastic. And of course, there's a card over there that I can't get. It could have been really good with blank card, but I have no idea. I hate the fact that I haven't found a single rune on this run yet. Not one single one. Runes work so well with blank card. Because pills don't work, but runes do. Careful. Competitive games? What do you mean? Like, MOBAs or something? You have to elaborate on your competitive games. Unless you mean like sports games or something? Oh god. Oh yeah, Charmed Dingle, that's pretty okay. Whoa! You are not supposed to be way over here, man. You are supposed to stay in the middle. See, you broke the rules, and when you break the rules, the penalty is death. Not a quick, swift death. It was a very, very slow death. But it did come nonetheless. Like, get to the top games? Are you talking like, you know, competitive scoring games? Where it's like, hey, these people have done this good with the scores, and you did this good, or something. Because I play one of those on Facebook, but I don't really think it's a very good game. I mean, I like the premise of the game is really good, but I'm not super excited about the Hermit there. But the competitiveness, I'm not really a big competitive one, because I honestly think that competitive games kind of suck nowadays because people can cheat, and a lot of people will hack. My cat's throwing up. I don't know what is his problem, but he's been throwing up a lot lately. At least this time it's on the floor, thank God. What was that one again? The Empress. Yeah, I'm gonna stick with the Devil. The only thing I worry about this is... Oh my goodness, I don't know. I don't know how well this is gonna work. Hope for a good secret room somewhere? Nope. That's okay. Over here, maybe? No. Maybe right here. Yeah, I figured it had to be there. Come on, good stuff. Pretty fly is pretty good. Tears down is so bad. Ugh. Yeah, like I play Criminal Case, I think. Agario. You start as a small ball and you have to make your ball bigger by eating smaller balls. I think I saw people playing Agario. I didn't really know what it was. In terms of stuff like that, like I used to play like Cookie Clicker and whatnot, and I thought Cookie Clicker was a pretty good game. I think that might be one of those that is like a progression kind of game. This is not gonna be good. I can't get hit once. It's gonna happen. I'm gonna get hit. Yep, just like that. That sucks. Alright, well give me a second. I gotta go, and see if my cat's okay and clean up that puke. So I'm gonna throw up my BRB. It should only be for just a couple of minutes. About 3 minutes. Be right back. Okay, back. Yeah, sorry about that. We have a bunny as a pet too, and for some reason, sometimes the hay ends up on the ground and our cat just thinks that he can eat the hay. Doesn't realize that his constitution is not suited to digest hay. He just thinks he can eat it. I have no idea why. Or it might have been a blade of grass, I'm not sure. He doesn't really digest grass either. Anyway, the seed for this run is going to be FRVVK4BG. Sounds kind of like a radio station. Oh my god, this is already a good start. I'm liking it. I like, what was that? Blood of the Martyr, I think? I think that's what it's called. It's a very good item. I'm liking that tinted rock, too. I would like a bomb, please? If I ask very kindly, do we think that the game will give it to me? Come on, please. Please, game. I'd be your best friend. No. Why such luck? Not gonna go in the curse for that either. Ooh, careful. Oh, the bunnies? Yeah, we keep our bunny in a cage. Cause the bunny and the cat, they don't get along well at all. We figured they might, because he never chases mice or anything like that. But for some reason, he just wants to eat that bunny. I do not understand why. And the bunny's getting big, too. And he still wants to take a bite out of her. They do not play nicely, that's for sure. But we just decided, yeah, we'll just get her a bigger cage and just leave her in there for some time. Maybe when she gets really big, he'll be afraid of her or something. Because I don't imagine that she's gonna hurt him. It's just I'm worried about him hurting her. Alright, let's take a peek inside the cursed room. Please be good. Oh my god, that is good. Oh, crap. Crap. Do not take so much damage. I cannot take one more hit or I will die on the way out. Phew, that was close. But, having the goat head is nice. Automatic deal with the devil. Even, what? Why did it not open the deal with the devil? It's supposed to open the deal with the devil even on the first floor. What the hell? Did they patch that? Oh, their bunnies hate each other. But love the cat? Wow, that's super weird. It does make sense, though. Because usually, I mean, cats and dogs are supposed to hate each other, but the cats and dogs over here get along pretty well. Somewhat, anyway. I would like to get into Whore of Babylon now, but I don't want to take any damage. A blood bank would be very nice. I don't think it's going to happen, but it would be super nice. Because I don't want to lose my black heart. Although, honestly, I don't have to worry about not taking red heart damage, because I get automatic deal with the devil. Guaranteed. We pee on each other? Well, that doesn't sound good. The bunnies pee on each other? That's pretty bad. They must really hate each other. I mean, I hate some people and I've never peed on a person before, so... That must be new, unfathomable levels of hate. Or maybe it's just because they're animals, I don't know. I am not Dr. Phil when it comes to animals. Oh god. Are these Mullabooms? I think they are. I think so. Oh, they're some kind of Mullaboom. Yeah, anyway. They're not actual Mullabooms, I don't think. I think only the ones that run after you and explode are Mullabooms. But I could be wrong. I'll have to do my homework with Isaac enemies here very soon when I want to unlock the Lost. Which I'm not looking forward to unlocking the Lost. Ugh. Bob's rotten head is so bad. It's really not a good item. You have some strange pets too? I would imagine. I think a lot of people have strange pets. Or maybe it's just the fact that some pets are strange. Monstrous Tooth is probably objectively a little bit better than Bob's Rotten Head. But not by much. Not by much at all. Now there is a library here, so could open it just like that. Oh man. I don't think you can jump over these. No, you can't. Oh wait, you can! What the heck? Unfortunately, I can't get back out without using a key. Drat. Oh, fine, I'll do it. I want Satanic Bible because it's so good. I want to sleep in the closet, not the nice, comfortable bed. I don't know. Wait, why what? Why your dogs want to sleep in the closet? And not the comfortable bed? I have no idea. Like, sometimes my cat won't even sleep on the comfortable bed that my wife made him. Right now he is, though. He's being a good kitty. I think it's just because animals are strange. Like, really strange. I mean, he keeps running away from the vacuum, even though I've never done anything with the vacuum to scare him, so... I mean, he should pretty much know that I have the vacuum under control, but still runs away from it. Ah, hello, Monstro. We meet again. I still need a little bit of a damage upgrade. A little bit more tears would be nice. But maybe I can get that from this deal with the devil. I would be willing to trade all my HP if I had to. Because War of Babylon sounds like a very good idea. And with this many utility hearts and the ability to make utility hearts on my own, yeah, War of Babylon sounds fantastic. I'll take it. Please be good. This is not good. I don't know if you knew that, Satan, but your deal is garbage. Totally wanted to get into War of Babylon, and you give me Guppy's Collar. How dare you? They run away from the vacuum? Yeah, exactly. It's weird though, the dog that we have here, my wife's sister's dog, she like hates the vacuum. She won't actually run away from it, she like tries to attack it. For some reason, even if it's not even on, like you'll be rolling it into the room to use it, and she'll try and attack it while you're rolling it. It's like, oh my god, I'm trying to transport the vacuum to my room so I can get chores done, and you're making it so that it's very difficult to do this simple task. It's super annoying. Of course, hopefully we won't be here forever. Just right now we don't have very much money because living in the US with no job, well, with me having no job, really sucks. And with nobody wanting to hire me, so I'm like, oh, whatever. But I'll try and take matters into my own hands, and it's not working out so much better either. But I'll tell you, I mean, I've already made 10 bucks, even though I can't do anything with it. That is 10 bucks that I actually did make all by myself. Took forever, but... that is real results, whereas filling out applications just gets the result of zero calls. Because apparently people hate me. Even though I'm a super good worker, like, I'm one of the hardest workers I've ever known. very strange. Yeah, that's not even how she is, though. Even on, she'll try and bite it sometimes. It's crazy. You would think she'd be incredibly afraid of it, but I guess not. This is probably worth it. It's quite a lot of money there. I'll take it. It's debatable whether that was worth it or not. My god, where is my blood bank? I need a blood bank so that I can enter Whore of Babylon like yesterday. This is way too slow. Never gonna get boss rush this way. Although it is 10 minutes and we're on caves or catacombs 1, that's not too bad. The moon might actually use that. Still debating on whether I want to use it or not. Wow, that was an interesting place for him to pop up. Good. Sure, I need keys. That is not a key! Again, game, I'm not sure if you understood that I said that I needed keys. Not half hearts. In fact, see, I was saying that I wanted to enter Horde of Babylon, which means don't give me red hearts. Come on. There we go. This is taking way too long. Did it all for the keys! Maybe I'll get a key as a reward. If so, then... I mean, not all will be forgiven, but some things can be forgiven. Not a key. Not a single key. That is really disappointing. Let's use our moon card. Get some more bombs. Sure. Why not? How did yesterday go? You mean with my stream? It was pretty decent, I'd say. I liked it. I had a good time. I was really hoping for a key in that rock. The key deprivation is real. With yesterday's stream, I ended up getting... I think two characters' post-it notes, like, almost completely filled out. Like, I got Eden to where he only needs boss rush. I'm not going to miss at all. Please die. That just does not want to die. Well, that worked. I don't know why his HP was just draining like crazy. Tears and shot speed, black heart, and three soul hearts. Decent, but I really need keys. I hate the fact that I have to leave my item room. Wait, maybe I don't. Hold on. Maybe I can find my super secret room right here. It's not keys. Seriously, not keys. I die a little inside knowing that I have to leave my item room and my shop there. One phrase to describe this run is key deprivation. Let's see if we can turn that around. That would be very nice. Come on, game. Work with me here. I think I'm playing okay. Oh my god, I have a lot of HP. I didn't even realize I had that much. I figured that the husk did a number on me, but I guess not. Or not that much, anyway. Whoa. Careful. Careful. This is the best room to fight Gluttony on. Because if he drops a HP up, you can actually pick it up. Well, that's not an HP up. maybe I'll get lucky and get an arcade. It's really bad. Oh yeah, go to spikes. That's very nice of you. Thank you. You want to go to the spikes too? Good job. Makes my life a lot easier. Probably not gonna worry about that. Certainly not gonna be opening that chest. I think I got Guppy's tail this run, actually. I think so. Did I get a Guppy's tail? I think I got Guppy's tail. That's probably why I'm getting something gold chest. I'm never gonna be able to open them. Unless I can get paperclip. Come on. Kidding me. Die, Larry Jr. I don't have time for this. Still wanna maybe try a boss rush? Or at least have a stab at it? Oh god. Still no keys. Come on, game. You can't hold out on keys forever. Can you? It's not physically possible, right? I mean, there's gotta be a time that you're gonna give me a key as a reward. Just one key, that's all I'm asking. That's a bomb. I have plenty of bombs just sitting around. I don't want them. It's a coin, I don't want that either. I mean, coins are nice, but I can't go to the shop without a key. God damn it. Leave this room. This is like the worst room ever. Because you have no room to dodge. And I get it like every single freaking run. Sucks. Let's see. Are you up California time? 1:30. Yeah, I should be up then. That would be what, 2:30 for me? Yeah. I'll definitely be up by then. It should work. And I think it's still on sale tomorrow, I believe. I mean, you might want to check. I'm not sure how long it's on sale. I was notified of the sale on Wednesday, so I don't really know if it's going to be till Friday. I think it is till the end of Friday, but I'm not sure. Yeah, not AM. Well, yeah, of course. Nah, I was thinking 2:30 PM, just after lunch. Which is kind of funny, because I don't eat lunch. This good? Please be good. Health up? That's not exactly what I was looking for. But I guess it's the thought that counts. That was really bad. Where are my keys? Seriously. But yeah, 8 p.m. was what I was thinking. I don't know how long the sale's gonna be on for. Like I said, you might want to check that out before you go to bed. I would check it out, but I still got a stream, so. Just all you gotta do is just go to the Steam store and just look up Skullgirls. Skullgirls. If I remember correctly, it said it was 3 days. But I'm not sure, because I'm not one that really knows about the midweek madness sales. Should I go for that? Do I have Guppy's Tail? No, I don't have Guppy's Tail. It must have been last run. I still have no keys. Really? It's going to be another floor of no keys. Wait a minute. Might still be able to get the item. It's possible. Come on. I don't think I would have got it anyway. That's not where my secret room is. It makes me cry small face tears. Oh, please give me keys. Please just give me like a boatload of keys. Alrighty. Well, money's okay too, because then I can play more and see if I can get some keys. At least just one key. Bombs are key. Bombs are key. Not bombs or key, but it is I can see forever, which is okay. No, come on! What? Speed up? Sure. Yeah, I need speed. Alright, let's see if I can find that other secret room. Maybe there's something good in it. Oh, it is in there. Not super useful. Because there's no arcade or blood bank. Such a pain. Well, I'm gonna blow this up and hope for a key. Really? I can't believe this game is really not giving me keys. That's two floors with no keys. This definitely is not gonna be boss rush then. Because I'm just not getting my items. In fact, this is gonna be a painfully long fight. Oh my god, yes. Painfully long. I would like to kill one of these gnomes. Please, like this one, please be dead. Thank you. Gotta keep my eye on Gertie's face so I know when he disappears. There we go. I like it. Oh, that was close. So hopefully one of these days I'll be able to get my hands on Afterbirth too. I would stream Afterbirth too. Because actually I kind of just fell into Isaac. Because I was wondering what game is the best to stream to start out with. And all the Twitch people were saying, well, Binding of Isaac is a really good one to start out with. You get lots of viewers this way because it's a pretty popular game, but it's not super popular. Because the super popular games, you don't want to stream those at first. Because there's like thousands of people streaming them. And so I was just thinking to myself, I was like, yeah, Binding of Isaac sounds pretty good. And so I tried it, and wow. It lasts till Sunday? Wow. I totally thought Friday. Man, I was way off. Well, that's super cool. The game does look pretty darn awesome, though. It looks a lot like Guilty Gear to me, and I love Guilty Gear. Nice. That was super good. Nope. Good. No, let's not worry about that rainbow poop. Yeah, it's definitely not going to be boss rush, unfortunately, but it might actually be a win. I might be able to sneak out a win here. It's going to have to be Sam Fisher style sneaking, though. Fun. I might even go ahead and stream it tomorrow too. Maybe. Either that or it'll definitely be next week. I'll have to find a little title screen for it and whatnot. Like I have my title for, the image for Isaac. Seriously, I can't believe I still have not found a single key. How is this even possible? RN Jesus, why have you forsaken me? Well, thanks a lot, Mr. Toxix. I do definitely appreciate it. Because, yeah, I certainly don't have the money. I could even prove it by showing you my analytics, but that would be just embarrassing. Especially when you can look up people like PewDiePie and realize they make millions of dollars on just ad revenue. Like, he makes $4 million a year on ad revenue, I think. ad revenue alone. And he doesn't even have to do anything. Like, he could just quit YouTube right now, and he could live in a lap of luxury for the rest of his whole entire life, and doing absolutely nothing but, like, sipping Long Island iced teas by the beach or something. Now that's residual income. That's kind of what everybody hopes to get into with YouTube, but I kind of didn't, because I'm like, hey, you know, I need to set realistic expectations for myself. I don't think I'm that good at videos and streaming and stuff. I probably will get better over time, though. I'm getting better at Isaac, I can tell that. I'm bad, that's for sure. Vinny's pretty bad at Isaac. I really don't need another speed up. I think it would give me detrimental speed when I end up getting the mini mush. Which does happen pretty often. Ooh, it's right here. Oh my god, I'm so fast, I can't dodge. So fast. I am glad that I'm good enough to keep you entertained. I do try my best, but I'm definitely not like all those other, I mean, there's, I've noticed some streamers out there that are just like, hey, I'm the greatest that ever was at streaming and stuff. I was like, I'm never that, I'm like Mr. Humble all the time. If anything, I'll be like, hey, I'm not that good or whatnot. Like if I was to stream League of Legends, I'd be like, hey, I'm a pretty average player at League of Legends. I wouldn't be all like, hey, I'm a pro. I'm fantastic at League of Legends. I do the best. And then go with like 10 deaths. And then be like, ah, oh, it was just the game trolling me, man. Some of them do it though. Yeah, if you want me to, I can call you Alex, that's no problem. Probably a little easier than Mr. or Toxics. As long as I can remember, it's gonna get a little, it's probably gonna get a little tough to remember everybody's names. But I know somebody came in last night and they were like, yeah, you can call me CJ. I'm like, okay. They were a streamer too, oddly enough. He's like, raid. And I was like, oh my god, am I getting raided? Are you kidding me? And it wasn't really a raid. It was just a guy that was done streaming Isaac. So he's like, I just thought I'd check out your stream. I was like, oh, that's cool. Not a real raid, but hey, one of these days I'll get a real raid, and then I'll be super excited. Someday. Who knows? I don't know if you know what a raid is. Oh shit. Oh god, this is gonna be so bad. I'm so glad I'm not going for boss rush now. I just gotta be careful. Come on. No. Be very careful. Alright, yeah, I'll try and remember. In fact, I might even put it in my little notepad. I put all my little stuff that I need to remember in my notepad. And it's not an actual notepad either, it's computer notepad. Because I'm too lazy to write stuff down. I type. Ah, Krampus. Oh god, please be Lump of Coal. It's probably not gonna be Lump of Coal, but I really want Lump of Coal. Hello, evil clan leader. Cool name. God, come on, Krampus. Please don't give me your damn head. I hate it. I hate it. I hate it. Please. I've asked you kindly. Thank you, good. See, maybe the game is kind of nice when you ask kindly, sort of. Sometimes. Maybe not always, though. Wow, that's like the, eighth newcomer that I found, I think? Oh, you got a good seed? Do lay it on me. I might go ahead and do a seeded run after this one, because I'm kind of tired of trying to make progress. Not doing a very good job. Alright. Just give me a second when you do get the seed, because I'll copy it into my notepad. And then I'll probably play it next. Just in case you want to stick around and see what the seed has to offer. I've gotten a couple good seeds though. Pretty good so far. I know you can't unlock anything with seeds, but hey, my progress is almost at a halt anyway. Come on, come on. Oh god, that was so close. Really? Come on. There we go. Oh. Cockfight? I love that seed. Welcome back, Alex. Ouch. I've already got my water. I always have water when I stream. It's neat. Oh, the cockfight seed is so good. Evil though, you spelled it wrong. Or did you? Wait. No, you might not have spelled it wrong. I don't know why it asterisked it out. I don't have any kind of filter on this chat, and yet it sees fit to filter itself for some reason. I don't understand. Like, can you see that, Alex? I don't know if you can see what he typed, because I just see three asterisks. Because if you can see it, then maybe I have a filter turned on or something for my chat only, and I need to like turn that off because I'm not a little kid. And I think I'm okay with the word cock, especially because I know what it actually means. Yeah, I'm just trying to see if he can see it. Because if so, I don't know why it's doing... Oh, it is start out? What the hell? I don't know why it's doing that. Because I don't have any banned words, so I don't... I don't know if maybe banned words means if somebody says that they get automatically banned or something. I don't think that's how it works, though. I'm pretty sure what it does is it just stars it out like that. I don't know, I'll have to check that out. For some reason, somebody was able to do the cockfight seed before. And now it's just like, hey, you can't say cock, how dare you. Well, it's all in context, Twitch, jeez. Stop having a hissy fit. But yeah, the cockfight seed is fantastic. I love that seed. It's a seed where every single... yeah, just like that. Bok bok chicken, exactly. Just like that. That's exactly what it is. Just like a cockfight. And it's such a good seed. It is, it works here. No, it's still asterisk for me. Here, hold on. Even if I put it like the seed, because the seed is like this. Oops, no. That's the seed, I think. Oh, it works. It works if you capitalize it, I guess. That's how I usually do seeds anyway. And it's seriously a great seed. One of the greatest seeds I've ever played. Let's see. Do I want to go in there? I probably... Oh, I could. And I very well may do that too, because that looks tantalizing, I gotta say. Okay, now if anybody didn't know about this, I learned this from Northern Lion. If you play these guys really quickly, you can play both of these for half a heart. As long as your speed's fast enough to play both of them. That was crappy. Full health. Full health. Two full healths. That's fantastic. And what is this? I found pills. So I guess it just doesn't like the lowercase cock. I have no idea. I mean, you can say something else like this. Watch. I'm sure you can say this. Yeah, see? You can say that just fine. That's a cuss word. And it's just like, hey, ass is okay. But cock? Hell no. Can't be letting you say that. This is Twitch. We let people stream GTA 5 with extreme nudity. But you can't say ass, I'm sorry. Or I mean cock. With lowercase. But uppercase is fine. Can you not even say it with uppercase, Mr. Toxic? Sorry. Like I said, it's gonna be hard to remember to call you Alex. I'll get it, though. I'm gonna use these full healths just to see if I can get this machine to pay out with something. Whatever it's gonna pay out with. Blood bag would be nice. I have the ability of picking up two blood bags here. I don't know if it's gonna work, though. How low I want to play it, though. Yes, I see the stars. Yes, I have no idea what you're saying. I mean, see, I don't think that's something that I can change either. Let me check and see. Yeah, there's nothing here. There's nothing in the chat options to change it. And I'm pretty certain that I don't have it, having any bannable words or banned words or whatnot. I don't think I'm gonna worry about the rest of those guys or the rest of the machines. I'm just gonna play this dude. Thank you, dude. That's pretty fantastic. What was that pill again? Speed up. Not so good. And this is the mom fight. You don't see the stars? What? Do you actually see the word? Oh, maybe... maybe only other people can see the stars. That's really strange. I don't have a key, so... won't be opening that or that. And blow up key donation guy? Yeah, that's probably a good idea. I should probably blow him up. Oh, so you can't see the stars either? Weird. Yeah, because I can't see my own stars either. Did you see the stars when I did the all caps? And I like Flatworm a lot. You know, I'm gonna take Flatworm. I like Flatworm a lot. Other people don't like Flatworm, but I think it's a pretty good worm trinket. I'm gonna have to take it. I'm just gonna have to hope to God that I don't take too much damage with Mom. Yeah, you do see the stars for all of them. Interesting. It's gotta be something with Twitch. There's gotta be something on my channel settings that I can change it, but I'm not sure. Or maybe it's just Twitch chat. It's weird because it never used to happen before, because somebody told me the cockfight seed before and it didn't asterisk it out. Oh, wait. It's because that's not how you spell it, I believe. In in Isaac, there is no O's. And there are no I's because they look too much like ones. So instead of having O's, they have zeros. And instead of having I's, they have ones. I will take the Polaroid. Or soul hearts. Wow. Thanks. Yeah, because I'm pretty sure the cockfight seed is actually done like this. Like that. Because I, like I said, I don't think you can put O's in. That's probably how people were getting away with it. Because you should be able to see that one. I can see that one. I'm pretty sure that's what it is. I'll probably go ahead and play that seed after this one. But I know you were saying you were gonna head to bed, so I don't know if you'll be able to see it. I have played the cockfight seed before, and it's a fantastic seed. It's absolutely amazing. Because what it does is it's perma-charm every single room for the enemies. So basically, you just watch back, or sit back and watch them kill themselves. Unless it's a room with one enemy. Then it doesn't work so well. I'm gonna have to keep my keys, so I'm probably not gonna be opening any golden chest. Because I'd really like to open my chests on the chest. Oh, careful. Where did I get this? Oh yeah, the flies from Rotten Baby. Nice. I like Rotten Baby. I think you're pretty good. Yeah, he left. I figured he probably would. A lot of people do that. They'll just pop in and be like, hey, I got a seed for you. Or even worse, you'll get someone to pop in and just spam the chat. Hate those guys. Twitch needs to do something about them. Because they'll just come in and they'll just, like, leave a link or something. And they won't even say hi or anything. It's like, oh man, just find somebody else's channel to do that, please. Because I'm too small to be getting spammers, please. I just want actual viewers that want to actually have intelligent conversations. Oh, a raid? What a raid is it's when a bigger streamer stops their stream. Like, say there's somebody above me that has like 5 viewers maybe or something, and he stops streaming, and then he sees that I'm streaming, and he sees that I only have like 1 viewer or whatnot, and he tells his viewers, he says, hey, I'm done streaming, so why don't you go watch this guy? That's what a raid is. Then they come in and they say raid, and there's like 4 people watching because they came from his stream. It's really cool. I've seen it happen, like on YouTube. There was this one guy that got raided while he slept, because he was doing this marathon for a charity, and it hurt to watch him fall asleep, because I know how that game is played, and I knew it was gonna be painful. Yeah, they pop in and go like that, exactly. But not quite like that, I don't think. I usually see other stuff. That was really bad. I can't believe that bomb didn't blow this up. Really disappointed in that. But yeah, like that guy, I feel really bad because he was playing Majora's Mask. And he was trying to do the cafe puzzle. The very last one where you have to wait until the very, last 3 hours or something like that until the moon's gonna drop? Something like that. And he fell asleep while waiting for Cafe to show up. Because he had been streaming for like 10 hours straight or something like that, and he was just dead tired trying to raise money for charity. And while he was asleep, he got raided. And there was just like 300 people in his chat just going absolutely insane while he slept. And it was just so funny if you read the chat. It was like, oh, like, this guy, is he seriously asleep and everything like that? Unfortunately, Twitch can ban you for that, though. Or suspend you, at least. I was like, that's not very nice. People can't help it if they fall asleep. I mean, if you're doing it on purpose, then yeah, I mean, I could see suspending them, being like, why are you streaming you sleeping? That's kind of dumb. But if it's an accident, I don't really think they should be suspended for that. Because it was clearly an accident. He just fell asleep right in his chair, just knocked out completely. It was like a 20-minute video, and his friends were just there, and they're like, oh my gosh, did he seriously fall asleep? And then you just saw like a whole bunch of people come in and be like, raid for charity, or something like that. It was great. I'm not gonna click it, don't worry. I could click it, but I don't know. Still gotta be doing this game. Which it's not liking me very much so far. I don't know how I feel about this run. It feels kind of comfy, but not very much of a winning position. It does feel a little comfy though. But yeah, I'll definitely show you cockfight. My god, that run, or that seed is so much fun. I did a seeded run once of cockfight, and it was just so good. By the way, with Conquest, if you stay down here at the bottom of the screen, you're kind of safe when he does that little dash attack. Because he never comes to the bottom of the screen. And you can just hit all of his multiple images and do damage. And I haven't even taken damage yet. I love this. He's dead. The pony is... it's not good. But I mean, flight would be nice. Oh, there's the miter. Not bad. Oh, it's a link to a trade on Steam? Ah, I see. It was the thing on Paste? Okay. That's alright, I definitely want that. Yeah, like I said, if I do stream Skullgirls, I'll probably just do like a Google search for a good Skullgirls image. And I'll put that as my Steam or stream icon thingy. Because I know how their icons work now, or their thumbnails. And so I like to have a thumbnail that's of the game, because all my other thumbnails look really bad on Twitch. Because they're all just a black screen saying starting soon and BRB. I was like, that's not really going to catch anybody's attention. Whereas the thumbnails with Isaac that I made are quite nice. Technically, I didn't really make it. I kind of stole the picture, but... hey, it's on Google. I'd say that falls under fair use. Because I didn't use any pirating software or anything like that. It was just there. Although I did edit it. So technically it's kind of mine now? Technically. Because I edited it to have my logo and everything. My channel logo and my stream name logo, LNS. Which is funny because now that I know about Northern Lion, I know that he does a stream called NLSS. And I was like, whoa, that's a lot of the same letters. Not in the same order, but the same letters. I was like, I swear I didn't copy Northern Lion. Because I didn't even know about him when I was started streaming. I just recently started watching him, and I've watched like over 100 episodes of him because he's super entertaining and he's a good Isaac player. And I'm getting pretty good tips from him. Some. And then I got a really good tip from him, which is always drop the left hand before you get to the chest. Always. You never want to have that stuff. No hacking or piracy. were used in the making of this vid. I would like to, but I'm not really big on disclaimers. Plus, it's not true for some of my videos, especially if I get into corruptions. Corruptions are all about piracy. Because, I mean, you gotta have ROMs, and ROMs are piracy. But you know what, I think to myself, you know, even if it's piracy, it's okay for me because it's gonna get to a point where you can't even play those games anymore without actually having ROMs and emulators. Because everything is gonna be too high-tech that there's just gonna be no way of playing the old games, like old N64 games. How can you play those without an actual N64, which I don't have? But you can't play them without a ROM or an actual N64. There's nothing that can play them. And ROMs play really well. And they're so easy, and, I mean, there is the fact that they're free, yes, but, I mean, honestly, how much is an N64 game gonna cost nowadays anyway? It doesn't cost that much. It costs like a quarter. Disclaimer, no disclaimers were used in the making of this vid. I like that. No disclaimers were used, no disclaimers are issued, and no claims are claimed. It's not my material. Well, I mean, it is my material, but the game is not my material. I did not make this game. I have made a game, but it is nothing compared to this game. My game sucks. And it's only made me like $6 in ad revenue. Because it's a bad game. Because people don't like idle games. I like idle games, though. I think even Cookie Clicker is kind of an idle game. Wow, this is not gonna be good, is it? I don't have very many red hearts. I can't really do this. My game is called Medieval Bar Idol, and it's on Congregate. And it took me forever to make, and it looks like garbage. But it seriously took a long time, and there were so many bugs to work out, and the game just plays itself. That's all it does. There is no user input in the game at all. You just watch bars go. Guppy's collar, why have you forsaken me? Why have you forsaken me? Why would you do this? Alright, so I'll show you what that seat is like. The seat is amazing. Pretty sure it's that. It's gotta be that, right? I mean, it's gotta be. Ooh, that is just not good. Reroll! Rainbow baby! I'll take it. Yep, this is the seed. Did you see it? Perma-charm every room. Look at that. They just kill themselves. And then you have to fight the one that remains. Yes, we are to watch the cockfight. It's fantastic. Look at them. They even shot each other. It's so good. It's so easy, too. I mean, if you're ever having a tough time with Isaac, just load up cockfight and you will have so much fun. Although, like I said, if there's one enemy, or like this guy who's spewing blood, they will revert back to normal. Like, see, he's gonna come charging you down. Because he's just one enemy, has nobody to charm against. That was pretty bad. Not like in the Curse of the Unknown, either. That's not very pleasant. They're gonna kill each other. Or maybe not, they're just gonna dance. Sweet rave party! They really are just dancing. Alright, I'll help him. There we go. I can't sit there and watch you guys dance forever. Come on. Oh, would that double trouble bosses? Yes, it would. And the good thing is, it does work on bosses. Come on, you guys can do it. Yeah, good job. It gives new meaning to the term love each other to death. That's basically what they do. It's super entertaining with rooms that have just tons of enemies in them. Which I'm sure we'll get to. Pin might... Nah, he's not gonna be useful. He's gonna be charmed, but it's not gonna be useful. I was gonna think he might be useful, but it would only be useful if he had that little Diglett guy with him, because they would fight each other. Until, obviously, the Diglett guy is gonna die, because he has way less HP than Pin. Probably not a reroll. I actually like that one. If it was something like a range up, I'd probably reroll it, but I like the safety pin. Oh, water's so good. I'm not gonna take Unicorn Stump. Probably gonna reroll it. Yes, shoot each other. You can do it. Boom! Do it again! Yes! Double KO! Fatality. It's not very good either. I can actually reroll that too. Yes! Do it! Fight to the death! Yes! On rooms where it has like the same enemies like that, it's really good. Wow, that was dangerous. That still could have really hurt me, that explosion, but it didn't, for some reason. Yes! Health up is fantastic. I'll take it. Small rock is very good. It is one of the highest damage up items in the game. Aw, you bastard. The funny thing is, when he spawns his spiders, they're gonna like instantly hurt him, because they'll instantly be charmed and they'll already be on his body. So every time he spawns spiders, it's basically just free damage to himself. Which I'm kind of okay with. I'll take that key. And go ahead and get this battery. And a key, but not the battery. Might be able to get one more reroll. One more than I would actually get. Yeah, looks like it'll probably work. Whoa, careful. Yep, there's my reroll. I'll go reroll that Book of Telepathy or whatever it is. Terrible item. Oh, I think it's a dummy's book to telekinesis? I don't know, something telekinesis. What is it? Telepathy for dummies, that's right. Reroll! That's not very good either. I'm gonna stick with the D6, I just want a passive item. Come on. You can do it. You can do it, I believe in you. Open this. Temperance is okay. I don't think I'm gonna really be using it. Let's give this another reroll real quick. Aw, I should not have stepped in here. I thought I already stepped in this room. Ooh, that's not good. Didn't get a charge, but that's okay. Reroll! That'll work. The relic is certainly passive, and a very good passive item at that. And with that, we shall say adieu to this floor. Wait a second. Didn't know this was here. Come on, you must come out. Oh, really? Do I have to let you out? All right, I'll do it. Just because I know you guys will provide me with entertainment. Go! Be free! Yes. It's so good. He ate his sibling, I guess. I guess they're siblings.